Hello everyone, this is CJ again. Trying to do a major job on my car in a minute. I really don't want to do it simply because I feel like it's going to be a massive job. But at the same time, 200 quid, because I work for my money. And yeah, I can easily say every penny counts. When you're a family man, when you've got kids, when you'd rather spend that money on the holiday somewhere, even though today's day and all that smell of Third World War happening in Europe. Anyway, on the positive side, I'm about to do this. On the negative side, I can't be arsed doing it. So let me show you what I'm about to do. Right, so I've got two front arms. The bushes on the front arms are gone. These are the ball joints. I've got two sets of them. And hopefully, I got two sets because they were a good price. This one is, as you can see, it's offset on one side, which means you can adjust them, which means there's a hole in there, which means the nipple goes in there and you can service it, put oil in there, not oil, the grease. And that is a rod ends, the rod end. Hold on, that is a rod end. So I gotta change two of these, two ball joints and two arms. So the front end will be sweet. Special. This was second hand. I bought it on the market. Facebook market, I think I bought it. £50. It looks like a brand new kit. I think they're like £150 for a whole kit. Everything in there. That's the main thing. Anyway, hopefully, we'll do it. Got my gun down here, right. So, I'm officially tired. I've been at it for 3 hours. I undone one bolt, which was that big massive one that holds the actual arm. Right, let me put the light on. Right, this ball joint, I undone that bolt there, that nut. Trying to undo that, I was stupid. I've done a big mistake. What I undone? I was trying to undo the bolt, this nut here, sorry. And something told me, take a hammer, hit on it, just to undo it. But the whole freaking thing was holding for me to undo the nut. Now it's all spinning. I can't hold on to this top. It's all spinning. This arm, because I undone that bolt, trying to undo the nut from underneath there. I undone the nut, definitely. Now I'm trying to hammer the freaking thing out, and then further down, which is that one, this one here, is pressed in ball joint, which is what I was supposed to do. I'm officially losing patience and everything. Got a little file here, literally took a couple of minutes to do that, and because I see that, I can just cut this nut off. So I'm gonna cut it off, open it up, change that, change this arm, and I say officially fuck that, the rest of it, I'm going to mechanic to get it done. I managed to cut this stupid nut off. Get this thing off. I'm trying to put a new, can't do it with one hand, rod end put it on there, and that one is off, so I just need to take that one off. I ain't doing the ball joints, that's for sure. The loads of brutal force and ball joint splitter, managed to take it off. Let me show you what it is. Right, this is the old one. This is the old one. It's not that bad, but the boot is knackered. But the main thing here, the rubber's gone. I'm not putting too much pressure with the finger. It's already moving. Imagine how much it's moving when there is a load on it. There's a split there. And that's the new ones. The new one of these, I already put it on. Just about to take this apart. It's on the ramp. It's all off. The ball joint is getting done. It's on the ramp at my friend's place.
If you know, you know.
All I'm saying is I would not trust anybody else. Number one. Number two. Ooh, for a second I thought that's something I've gone through. The main thing is my back seized up and I couldn't do any work apart from them two stupid little things. I'll show you later a video. Right, the ball joint. This stupid thing is the main thing that goes wrong when you... The kids might be watching this video, so messing about. I'm gonna try not to swear. So when you're messing about with different sizes of wheels, suspension, I'm on lowering springs. What happens is the ball joints, bushes, all that kind of rubbers, that stuff gets messed up. So this one's still to do. I'm on spacers, actually adapters. This is fiber 115 Chrysler. The wheels are fiber 120, which is the BMW. This is MTEC discs, or rotors, as Americans say. EBC Reds, because I had them for ages and I haven't had an opportunity to use them. Lowering springs, this thing's all right for now. This stuff, I haven't done anything. My man's gonna do it. Oh, yeah, new calipers. That's it. The arm is now free. The ball joint is... ball joint is really loose. The MOT man said the wall needs to be changed. Yes. Thank you. second side getting done. Hopefully everything's going to be as good as the other one. But then again, it's getting done by a pro.
This is how we talk the thing, doodah, doodah. Maximum importance talking. No guessing. There you go. T for tight.
Cool. So, all we've done is the arms, the truck rod ends, ball joints, which is hopefully will be good, but it's what's the word? They're a new generation of ball joints. I'm not recommending it to everybody, but I will see how it goes. Basically, they are adjustable. Hopefully, that'll help me with the camber. So, CJ again. It is already next day, and I'm about to go and get my car. Wheel alignment sorted out, the geometry. So, because yesterday I've done the front arms, I've done ball joints, and I've done, oh, that's really sunny. And I did the track rod ends. When I say I did, I'm not the one who did it. That's proper sunny. A friend of mine did. I need the shave. Anyway, so the car is on the wheel alignment right now. Managed to get on the ramp. Done. Geometry had to do. Geometry done. I get a nail in the tire. Seriously. It's either one thing or the other.